Time now for our Sunday morning Q&A. Joining us this morning, Congressman John Sarbanes. Thank you so much for coming in.
My pleasure.
Good to see you. It's been a tough week for you guys.
It has been. We're trying to reach, a solution on this debt ceiling issue. I think everybody there knows that we have to raise a debt ceiling because you want America to pay its bills. Mm-hmm. And obviously there's a lot at stake. But some of those bills that we need to pay are Social Security checks, Medicare benefits, and so forth. So you got everybody, I think, is working very diligently to try to find a solution so we avoid a default.
Let's talk about a little bit of the consequences since you brought them up. I mean, we have a lot of elderly out there who they hear Social Security. I mean, Congressman Cummings said he was at Artscape. That's the number one thing people wanted to know. How likely a scenario
You know,
is
I
that?
Had the same experience. I was at a number of events in the last 2 days, and I had a lot of seniors coming up to me because that's what they're hearing, that maybe those checks aren't going to go out. I can tell you that probably the most powerful force that's working on members of Congress right now is knowing that those checks, Social Security checks, Medicare benefits, do have to keep going out as regularly scheduled. And so I think that's why we're working so hard to make sure that we do this. The other thing, of course, is if you default, then the market goes haywire. You get interest rates jumping up and so forth, and that's a shock to the economy.
Right.
And the number one thing people are concerned about right now is making sure the economy gets back on track, that we're creating jobs and so forth. So we don't want to do these things that are going to undermine that effort.
Right. Or jeopardize our place in world economics.
Absolutely. I mean, we're regarded, the full faith and credit of the United States is something that's valued very highly around the world. You don't want to put that at risk.
All right, and so you've had to have the president come out and say, come on, everybody, let's play nice together. House Speaker Boehner's spokesperson said, the lines of communication are still open. But are you feeling that? Do you see that going on?
I think the lines of communication are open on many different tracks. There's probably three or four different tracks that people are working on right now. So hopefully a solution will appear in one of those tracks. The president, I think, has said, if we're going to solve the debt and deficit problem, everybody's got to participate in that. So on the one hand, that means you look at where you can find savings, where it's appropriate to have some cuts put in place. But at the same time, you got to look at the revenue side.
Right.
And there are people out there, there are wealthy corporations and wealthy individuals who can afford to contribute their fair share to helping us solve this problem. And that's where a lot of the debate is going on right now. I mean, the average American looks at what, Wall Street gets in bonuses and so forth, and they say, are those people going to step up, and are they going to help us solve this problem too? So it's got to be a shared solution.
And so it seems like he continues to come up against a brick wall when he says the wealthiest Americans need to be taxed.
There are some elements that are just dead set against the idea that everybody ought to be contributing their fair share, including those who've done the best in our economy. And I think the average person out there says, wait a second. If we're going to make a sacrifice, if we're going to make a contribution, everybody ought to be participating in that. So hopefully that'll be the solution that we get to over the next few days, and we'll avoid raising, or defaulting, rather, on that debt ceiling.
Because you're talking to a lot of people who have taken cuts and who've taken furloughs and who've been laid off.
I talk to seniors. They're on a fixed income. Mm-hmm. They keep having this prospect coming at them that they're going to get hurt. They don't think that's fair. You look at people out there trying to get a job or struggling, families that are struggling. They are actually ready to step up and make a little bit of a sacrifice to help us get through tough times. But they want to know that everybody's participating in that. That's the key.
Is the big holdup the Tea Party?
There's labels on different elements inside Congress right now. There is a group of people that came recently. Some of them are Tea Party, some of them may not be Tea Party, and I don't dismiss the Tea Party out of hand, but there are folks in the chamber right now who are just, they got their heels dug in on this notion that, we won't go. We're not going to look at raising taxes on even the wealthiest Americans and so forth, and I think they're creating an obstacle right now, and hopefully we can break through that in the next few days.
Let me get some viewer questions in real quick. This isn't the first time our government has been in a deadlock this year. At what point will politicians begin to lay aside less important personal agendas for the good of the people? Your constituents need jobs.
I hear that frustration. We had the whole government shutdown debate, right, to put people on edge. Now we have this debate going on. People get fed up with that. I was in a 4th of July parade, and some guy yelled out to me, get a budget. You know, just get it done. Right, and I think that's what the average person is saying. We need to solve this now.
Okay, here's another question. Mr. Sarbanes, since the Senate and Congress are elected by the people and are representatives of the people, then why is it every decision you all vote on, every first thought when voting is first based on banding together just to vote against the other party? It just shows us you are not your first interest. We are not your first interest. Your party is.
It's a fair question. People see this bickering, and they want us to get past it. I don't have an easy solution to that. I'm certainly somebody who's open to working with people across the aisle, and I've tried in the legislation I've introduced to build bipartisan cooperation around things. But, you know, you've got a sort of pitched battle, and there are some elements in the press, I'm not saying here,
not here.
But who like to kind of get these things churned up. That doesn't help either. Mm-hmm. So we do need to get back to where we're working together to solve these problems. The president has certainly made the call for that, and I hope that you'll see people in the chamber responding to that in the next few days.
All right, and just like our viewers wrote in here, people want to voice their opinion to you and to other members of the Maryland delegation. They just need to pick up the phone or send an email?
Oh, absolutely. We get a lot of communication from our constituents, and we benefit tremendously from that.
So give you a call.
Absolutely.
All right, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
Good luck this week.
I appreciate it.
Well, next Sunday, our guest will be Terry Owen from the MTA. And if you have a question for the MTA, send it in. Email those questions to SundayQuestions@WBALTV.com. Again, that's SundayQuestions@WBALTV.com. Don't go.